Ten Flying Brooms. Written by Alana Oliver. Illustrated by Kyle Poling. 10 flying brooms zoomed swiftly through the night. Their witches were gone. They were nowhere in sight. The brooms began their hunt at this spooky old house. I heard a witch's cackle, squeaked a tiny timid mouse. Then down below they saw a glow coming from under the porch. Cried Witchy Woo, Broom One, Yoo-hoo, waving her wand like a torch. Broom One and Witchy Woo made a pair. 9 brooms flew alone through the air. Is that Storm there? Witchy Woo cried from below. I think that's her red hat on that big giant crow. Up in the sky the crow did fly with Storm riding on top. Broom Two flew high, poked Crow, oh my, and Storm fell down kerplop. Broom Two and Storm made a pair. 8 brooms flew alone through the air. Bree was in a rush, Storm said. She was running up the stairs, chasing something fast and small with lots of yellow hairs. Broom Three went up and spied a pup that Bree was snuggling tightly. Can he come too? Asked Bree to Woo. Of course, Woo said politely. Broom Three and Bree made a pair. 7 brooms flew alone through the air. Bree told the brooms she saw Batty Sue heading for the shed. She was looking for her bat who needed to be fed. Inside the shed, upon her head, was a bat. Oh me, oh my! Broom 4, hello, time to go, and they flew off in the sky. Broom 4 and Batty Sue made a pair. 6 brooms flew alone through the air. But where's Broomhilda? Batty Sue asked, weaving with her spiders. Let's look for her out back, but beware, these spiders are great hiders. Broom 5, I'm here, Broomhilda cheered from deep inside the forest. Zip and zoom went her broom, followed by the witchy chorus. Broom 5 and Broomhilda made a pair. 5 brooms flew alone through the air. Time was running out when they flew over a lake where Miss Trix was swimming. There was no mistake. I'm here, Broom 6, cried wet Miss Trix, and they flew to the water. We can't be late. We need Miss Tate. And Tabby, can you spot her? Broom 6 and Miss Trix made a pair. 4 brooms flew alone through the air. A hooting sound came from above. It was Tabby's owl. Tabby was scared, the owl said. She heard a noisy growl. Broom 7, look! The branches shook. They all flew over to see. Tabby stood, wearing her hood. Thank goodness you're here for me. Broom 7 and Tabby made a pair. 3 brooms flew alone through the air. The moon was high in the sky, so the brooms flew back to the gate. I hear a wolf howling, Tabby shivered, and also wild Miss Tate. As 8 swooped in, Miss Tate gave a grin and brushed the dirt off her knees. Broom 8, said Miss Tate, we mustn't wait. To the fire there, if you please. Broom 8 and Miss Tate made a pair. 2 brooms flew alone through the air. Eve's over by the fire, Tate told the crew with a grunt. She's been up to something while the brooms were on their hunt. Tate led them to the smell of stew, which Eve was standing over. You're right on time. It's time to dine, said Eve. Broom 9, come closer. Broom 9 and Eve made a pair. 1 broom flew alone through the air. Suddenly, they spied Witch Gwen stuck up in the great clock tower. The clock struck 12 and all called out, Hurrah, it's witching hour. Come get me 10, squawked Giddy Gwen. And don't forget these kitties. The time is here to spook, my dear. Let's fly away, my biddies. All 10 brooms had found their pairs. Now all flew swiftly through the air. Together just in time, the witches and their brooms for a flying Halloween show underneath the moon. Thank you for joining Mrs. Lindsay for 10 Flying Brooms by Alana Oliver. I can't wait to go on another book adventure. Come back to Mrs. Lindsay's Book Nook, where everyone is a reader. Be sure to subscribe. See you next time, readers.